Well, both surprised and not surprised. Surprised that it's happened again. Not surprised because it happens again and it will happen yet again. Those who are now entrusted with developing certain aspects of the art world in Singapore, particularly the public spheres, the museological spheres, in conversations with them, I gather that the absence of such a academic capacity and facility in Singapore, not just in the teaching of history, but let's say the teaching of museology, curating, all of which are highly skilled capacities, are nowhere in sight here. And yet, we are developing institutions which require such skilled and trained and sharply delineated individuals. So there's a mismatch, in my view, in building the infrastructure and not correspondingly developing the content for that infrastructure. Who are these people who are going to run it? I'm not personally against somebody from the botanical gardens or an ex-Navy commander coming into these establishments, but they cannot suddenly be the most prominent people doing that. They can be part of it. I once asked the late Dr. Earl Liu, a charming, wonderful, witty person, I said, Earl, you are a medical professional, and then and you are prominent in the art field, you are the chairman of the art museums and so on and so forth. Wonderful, it is a celebration of your versatility, your worldliness, your capacity to move from one world to another, I applaud. But I said, can I also emulate what you did and become the chairman of the medical association? He laughed derisively and said, no, of course not, and you know the reason. I said, no, tell me what the reason is. And he said, Saba, you're not a medico. I said, exactly, exactly. Why is it possible for one and not the other way around? And I can only say that it works because the art world advantageously works to include everybody in its sphere. But that is wonderful, but should there not be a corresponding professionalism in that whole environment? It's well and good for ex-admirals and ex-whatever it is, wherever they come from, the zoo or whatever it is, to come in. Okay, it's fine, but what are you doing here? Why? What credentials do you have to come in here? And why do we not have persons from the world of art itself with sufficient credentials to be up there as the chief executive officers and so on and so forth? And we have only ourselves to blame because we have let everything down, we have let everything to slip and slide, assuming that the world of art, like the world of sport, can traipse along on an amateurish level. All you need to do is be sufficiently interested, and that dreadful word which everybody uses, misuses, you have to have passion for it, and that's enough, baby.